Oh boy, you know, I was thinking today, it's getting harder and harder to do this bit because, like, you posted a thing on Tumblr called What Is Wrong With You? And I was like, you know, we do a bit every week called What the Fuck Is Wrong With You that's supposed to be funny, but more and more, you're just looking around at the world and honestly saying that with no humor whatsoever.
Yeah. Well, don't worry, there's plenty of horrible
things. Now I kind of know how Stephen Colbert feels. Like, he's run out of satire because reality has surpassed him. And he's like, well, fuck it, I'm just going to do a late night talk show because I can't be more absurd than reality.
Yeah, you've completely out-absurded me. I'm done. I retire. Unfortunately. Like,
the humor has gone out of the fuckery.
Well, not entirely. We've got plenty of stuff tonight. Although I do have to say our first story is a little bit sad and baffling at the same time. So
saffling?
Saffling? No, that's not. Stop trying to make saffling happen. Here we go. Each week, Catherine goes out worldwide, interwebs, off radio, that their audience finds all sorts of horrible stuff, brings it back here for a little segment we like to call What the Fuck Is Wrong With You? And, okay, crazy. Did you have sex ed?
I'm crazy.
Wow, I didn't.
You
expect
did?
The last, no, I didn't expect the last two words, and I was like, TMI.
Because I know, when I was in high school, they gave us the sex ed class.
Yeah, we had it in junior high.
It's when they say, okay, all the girls go there, all the guys go here.
Yeah, they didn't actually separate us either.
They didn't?
Mm-hmm.
They separated our, well, I was in the South, so, you know.
I went to public school in the ghetto.
Well, the thing is, people, we have reached this point, at least in America. I found it in other countries, they're baffled by us. But in America, we have reached this weird point where we are just simply terrified of our bodies. And that's why this story, this is a little sad, our first story this week. And just half of young women can't locate their vaginas.
This was a subplot on Orange is the New Black, season 2.
Yes, I remember. I actually watched it. God help me, I watched it.
It was, they were all arguing over whether you pee and give birth out of the same hole. And it was the transgender woman that had to teach them all.
And this is worse because I expected this to be America, but guess what? It's not. Half of young British women don't understand the basic anatomy of their vaginas, the study showed. Out of 1,000 women surveyed, just half...
British women have vaginas? I thought British people were made entirely out of tweed.
Girlfriend's British, damn it.
Like, really, really fabulous scarecrows that drink tea and have cool accents. No?
Out of 1,000 women surveyed, just half of those aged 26 to 35, just half could locate their vagina on a medical drawing. In contrast, the majority of the older women, 66 to 75, were able to label the body parts of the diagram. Study by a women's cancer charity, the Eve Appeal, also found that less than a quarter of women aged 16 to 25 didn't feel, quote, well-informed about gynecological health issues.
So we've gotten worse.
Yep. 1 in 5 young women were unable to name a single correct symptom of any of the 5 gynecological cancers, affected womb, cervix, ovaries, vagina, and vulva. At nearly a third of the women aged 16 to 35 said they avoided going to the doctor with gynecological issues due to embarrassment. And 1 in 10 said they found it very hard to talk to them about their concerns. The study also said that they found young women were uncomfortable with the word vagina, as 40% of 16 to 25-year-olds said they use names such as, quote, lady parts or women's bits instead.
My work has been commended as being strongly vaginal. The word makes men uncomfortable. They're happy to talk about their dick or their Johnson, but simply the word vagina.
You know, you're talking about how the parody has become reality. Holy shit!
Help us, Maude Lebowski.
The fucking Big Lebowski.
I'm going to cut my hair like Maude Lebowski and start doing vagina painting.
The Big Lebowski is making relevant social commentary.
Here's the thing, like, I'm horrified, but I'm not shocked that women can't identify the vagina on a map. I'm more horrified that they're not willing to talk to their doctor about health problems. You don't want your vagina rotting out. Like, if something's wrong with it, you're going to want to see to that. You need that for things.
That's what the gynecologist...
Even if you're not using it, I think we did this with breasts a few weeks ago. Even if you're not using it for a biological purpose, it's not something you want rotting and falling off.
No.
You don't want any part of you rotting and falling out. No. You just don't. You don't want cancer anywhere, whether you're using it or not. Left pinky cancer, still really bad.
But just, that's the whole point of a gynecologist. They're there to handle that specific part of the body. They went to school for 8 goddamn years.
I gotta say, I always found it weird that, like, I always found male gynecologists a little bit weird. And I know that's kind of wrong, but, like, you decided to devote your life. That just, something ain't right about that. I don't know.
Dude.
It's like any doctor that decides to focus their whole life on feet, like...
Well, no, dude.
What's really going on there?
I am a fan of the vagina, and I can understand dedicating yourself to the preservation and continued good health of the vagina. I can understand that.
Yeah, but see, that's what I'm talking about, though. Because why? I sense an ulterior motive. This isn't like an altruistic thing.
It's a conspiracy.
And that weirds me out a little bit.
There's a vagina Illuminati, is what you're saying.
Well, you're not supposed to know about that. And Omega and Hagen will be there soon to kill you.
Well, no, that's
they are our high mistresses, after all.
That's going to happen anyway. Eventually. I've pretty much foreseen that's how I'm going to die. The Amanda's going to kill me. I already know that. I'm not even kidding.
Can I have your show? It'll be like the Tara and Bridget. It'll be like Sonny and Cher, but Tara and Bridget. We'll do little skits. We'll sing I Got You, Babe.
If you can figure out the buttons, you're welcome to it.
That will be my undoing.
Yeah. So, moving along, we're going to begin the Drug-a-palooza now. So are you familiar with the service called Uber? Do you guys have that? Yeah.
Well, yeah, it's like... hipster amateur cabs.
Yeah. If you aren't aware of this at home, what Uber is it's a service where you get an app and you push the button and you say, hey, could you bring a car to drive me places? And it does. And it's a service.
And just about any asshole with a car can drive you around.
Yeah. They don't have to be licensed or accredited by the tax. And this is actually...
any fucking asshole can drive you around. It's like takeout murder.
Well, this has actually become an issue in states like California, where they are passing legislation to outlaw it.
It's a big thing in New York City, too.
Yeah, because the cab companies...
There's another one, I forget what it's called, but they put big pink mustaches on all the cars.
Yeah, which is odd, but okay. Because do you really want to be riding around in the pink mustache mobile?
That's how they mark them. Like, cabs are yellow... this, you use your regular car, but you have to hang this giant pink mustache off it. You shouldn't want to get in a car with anybody that's willing to do that.
Well, we have, and I was talking about the legislation in California, and we've got a little bit of irony on this one. They don't want these unregulated cab companies, but just after signing... the law, or passing the law that would make Uber illegal, Senator Ben Huso, profoundly sorry after DUI arrest.
Oh, no.
Senator Ben Huso, Democrat San Diego, was arrested early Friday morning on suspicion of driving under the influence of alcohol. Officers observed Hueso driving the wrong way on 15th Street. Officers reported seeing the vehicle make a U-turn and pulled the driver over at a parking lot. Powell said officers identified the driver as Hueso and he was alone in the car. He showed, quote, objective signs and symptoms being under the influence of alcohol and being given a field sobriety test.
I bet he's uber embarrassed.
Oh. There we go. There
sitting we on go. That one for a while. Took me forever to read that.
You know, whatever objections, and some of the objections to Uber are really, really strong. Don't you think that maybe after signing a bill that would remove a cab service, maybe going and drinking and driving.
Don't do the thing that makes a cab service necessary and helpful.
Yeah. Because Smafty in the channel. Go fuck yourself, San Diego. I mean, just.
Yeah.
It just. Oh, that's one of those foresight kind of things. Like, well, just taking care of cab service. Time for beers.
Man. Do they have official cab service in San Diego?
Oh, yeah, of course they do.
Because that's part of the big debate in New York City, is New York City has official unionized taxi service. So all these upstarts are kind of fucking up their program. And they're all heavily regulated, and these things aren't.
Yeah.
So New York City is starting to regulate all these little indie services and make them get the same permits and all.
Yeah, and I have no problem with that because they need to have them.
I don't want to get in a car with any fucking hipster who put a pink mustache on their car. I'm not interested in being made into a suit today.
That should actually be one of the first regulations. Get rid of the fucking pink mustache. What are you?
Well, someone was good enough to. It's Lyft. That one's called Lyft. L-Y-F-T. Yeah,
get rid of the pink mustache because you're not.
But there is a certain degree of just safety concern. Like, you get into a yellow cab in New York City, the guy's permit is there. You know his name. They're regulated. Like, they have a number. If something goes horribly awry.
Yeah, with Uber, you get in the cab. He's like, hi, I'm Bob. You know he's Bob? You don't know if he's Bob.
Someone to report them to. It's a regulated service. You just get in some asshole's car because you have an app? No one ever hears from you again? Well,
there's an app for that.
I don't think there's an app for that. There's not a Find the Body app just yet. You know? How many people do you think die with their smartphones on them?
God, Tara.
I'm sorry, it's morbid, but that's $1 million fucking movie. You know how many people are probably out there running in a ditch with their iPhone in their pocket?
Jesus Christ.
I'm just saying.
You get some dark territory here. Jesus.
I'm just saying. This dark world.
God damn. No, but seriously, I mean, if you're going to sign this shit into law, a little foresight into what, you know, you're not helping your cause there.
Yeah.
Well, it only gets worse. This is just one after another.
Isn't the Find the Body app called Siri? No, I'm pretty sure Siri can't do that.
No. Siri used to be able to tell you where to bury the bodies. Now it won't tell you anymore.
My sister did once throw her phone and yell fuck, and Siri asked her if she kisses her mother with that mouth.
Which I'm sure diffuses the situation nicely.
Oh, yeah, that really. Well, my nephew thought it was hilarious. My sister less so.
So, we're moving to Florida, of course.
Of course, we got to make our weekly jaunt to Florida. I feel like you should add into your opening credit sequence that gif of Bugs Bunny
sawing Florida off. Yeah, yes. That's one of those.
It should just be part of the show open.
You know how we keep saying what was wrong with the old drugs?
Yeah.
This is another vote for the what was wrong with the old drugs. 3, hallucinating on drugs, claim to be attacked, arrested on drug charges. Jackson County Sheriff's Office received a 911 call from a newspaper delivery person on Little Dotham Road. The caller reported 3 individuals yelling for help from the second floor of a residence. Individuals stated they had been shot at and held hostage for several hours. When the officers arrived, the subject initially refused to come outside because they feared the attackers might still be in the bottom floor. Once contact was made, the 2 men and 1 woman reported they had been attacked by several persons but could not provide any descriptions. Female reported she'd been stabbed and the knife broken off in her abdomen. Further investigation revealed she only had a superficial scratch. Furthermore, all the injuries received by the individuals were self-inflicted while attempting to fight off the attackers. Investigation revealed there was never anyone at the home beside the 3 individuals, and no one was attempting to cause harm.
Obviously, they were trying to carve out the chestbursters. Whoever locks them up is going to be really sorry.
The remnants of a, quote, shake-and-bake meth lab was found in the residence, along with several ingredients used to manufacture methamphetamine. Also discovered was a small amount of finished methamphetamine product, along with straws and pipes used to ingest, inhale, or smoke illegal narcotics.
I have a big problem with the term shake-and-bake meth lab for a few reasons. One, my parents made a lot of shake-and-bake shit when I was a kid, and that stuff tastes horrible. And I just, in general, don't like thinking about it. Like, sugar-coated pork chops? I don't know who thought that was a good idea. But I just don't like thinking about it. 2, that said, when you think shake-and-bake, you think something really benign and easy. And
it's shake-and-bake, and I helped!
Exactly. That should never be associated with crystal meth.
Yeah, if you don't understand how this works is you put the ingredients together, you get a soda bottle, you put them in the soda bottle, and then you shake the soda bottle.
Isn't there a really high probability that you will fucking explode?
Possibly, yes. People have set themselves on fire doing this.
I don't understand drugs that involve possible self-immolation.
Or in this case, why would you do a drug that they armed themselves with a 12-gauge shotgun and a 22 rifle, 40 rounds of 12-gauge ammunition, an unknown number of 22 rounds were fired from inside the residence. They fired 40.
They're really, really lucky nobody's dead.
40 shotgun rounds.
Really lucky nobody's dead.
That entire place looks like Swiss cheese right now.
Or that nobody's hand was blown off. Or
holy, yes! That is, do you remember that, I don't know, have you ever seen Predator?
To no one's surprise, no.
Okay, there's one scene in Predator.
I've seen parts of Alien versus Predator. I was really confused, because I've never seen Alien or Predator, so.
There's one scene in Predator where the Predator's invisible in the jungle, and some guy goes, look, there it is! And they just sort of unload every fucking weapon they have into the fucking jungle, and they don't hit shit. That's what I'm thinking of right now. It's just standing around a circle shooting at imaginary shit.
I never understand why they do that in movies. Why they just sit there going, when they don't even know something's there. You're going to need that ammo when something's actually there. Don't shoot at the hypothetical. Don't blow all your ammo on the hypothetical.
Oh.
Save your ammo for the actual. Because when the actual shows up and you have 1 bullet left, you're going to be really sorry.
And 40 rounds, that means there was some reloading involved.
Yeah, because shotguns, you have to reload like every shot or two, don't you?
Well, if it's
I only know that from watching Supernatural.
If it's a double barrel, you have to, every shot. If it's a pump action, it takes like 4 to 6 rounds. But still, 40 rounds, that meant you shot it dry, you reloaded, and you kept shooting. That's not a drug I want to be on!
I recant my statement about whoever incarcerated them is going to be sorry, because clearly these 3 people are being protected from on high for a higher purpose. Obviously, these are the 3 that are going to save the world. Because that's a goddamn miracle.
Yeah.
That's an oxymoron.
These are 3 people who should be dead.
It's an oxymoron. You can't really say goddamn miracle.
I mean, have you seen Buckshot?
Not up close. I saw those pictures of Dick Cheney's poor hunting buddy.
Well, that was birdshot.
Oh.
Buckshot.
Same thing.
Yeah, birdshot's tiny, teeny, little tiny BBs. Itty bitty ones. Buckshot, they're like about the size of ball bearings. And they pack a bunch of them into the shell, and that they just make holes in everything.
Like, yes, Vincent Vega, I am saying, God, stop those bullets.
So you're saying an angel came down.
Yes, I am.
To what end, though? What?
And that angel is wondering who they pissed off right now to get that detail.
Man, I gotta save
the meth heads detail.
Well, this next one was a little less deadly, but a little more stupid.
The three wise men are now smoking the frankincense. Yeah, they are. In gold thong.
This one's from Texas. You know all those old stories about the rock stars who used to trash their hotel rooms?
Old stories? Didn't you want to do that last week?
I didn't know that.
I'm making that up, but I think it's fair to assume that you probably did.
Possibly. Well, apparently, you know, the classics never go out of style, even though this guy wasn't a rock star. He certainly was partying like one. Texas man who threw chair beer bottles from balcony was found naked with bag of cocaine. Austin Reagan's 33 allegedly hit a hotel worker with one of the items thrown from his 16th floor balcony. The guy's okay. Prompting staff to visit his room, they found him unclothed.
Look at him blue stealing up that mugshot.
Yeah, he's like, what? Is he duck? He's like semi duck. He's semi duck face there. He's like approaching duck face. Austin Reagan's allegedly went into meltdown after being asked to leave the bar area at a at W Hotel in Fort Lauderdale.
Yeah, you haven't heard of those?
No.
They're pretty swanked, I think.
The 33-year-old from Woodland is accused of tossing the glass containers 160 feet to the ground. Cops claim he also threw a chair over the edge, which ended up hitting hotel worker Rodney Moore, who was walking on the driveway below. Moore was taken to a nearby hospital. Police said his injuries were not serious. I think Moore would disagree with that. That's one of those, the fucker hit me with a chair from 160 feet.
Can you imagine you're minding your own business at your job and a fucking chair falls out of the sky? At 160 feet, as far as you're concerned, that shit fell out of the sky. You have been smoked by the god of furniture.
And the first thing I'm thinking is, big titty naked women don't just fall out of the sky every day, you know? Sorry, I had to go with the Jay and Silent Bob on that one, but still.
I mean, it's Florida, so they might.
No, this one's Texas.
That's dog mob, because he says that right after Chris Rock falls out of the sky.
This one's Texas, though.
Fort Lauderdale.
Fort Lauderdale, Texas. There's a Fort Lauderdale, Texas. Oh, he's from Texas, man? No, it happened in Fort Lauderdale.
Fort Lauderdale, Texas.
Okay, my bad. No, this was Florida, too. Oh, man.
I'm relatively confident there is no Fort Lauderdale in Texas.
Well, I'm not.
But I want there to be.
Maybe there. Yeah, hotel staff visited Reagan's room following the incident and allegedly found him completely naked. Room's chair was missing. There's glass on the bathroom floor. A bag containing a white powder, which later tested positive for cocaine, was allegedly in plain view on a counter.
You know what? At least it was outside his person.
Yeah, you know, that's sad. We get into one of these stories, where, like, at least it wasn't in his butt.
Right.
That's, oh God. So many things here. Really, you have that much cocaine and you're going to call attention to yourself.
Well, if you have that much cocaine, who cares if they kick you out of the hotel bar?
True! Exactly! Exactly.
Go to your room and do all your cocaine.
Right.
And drink out of the minibar.
So I don't need your shit. I've got cocaine. Who the fuck cares if you can't get Kahlua? You've got cocaine!
Like, did he need mixers for his cocaine? Is that a thing that people do?
Oh god, I hope not.
Because girls on my baton twirling team used to mix pixie sticks with Zima and said it tasted like Kool-Aid, so...
Yeah. You mix your cocaine with whiskey and it tastes like loneliness.
If you break it down, that was a really weird sentence. Girls on my baton twirling team, pixie sticks and Zima.
Just...
But yeah, maybe he's making cocaine Kool-Aid for the kids.
And at what point was nudity required for this?
Well,
if you're at the point where you're naked snorting cocaine in a hotel room and you're not worth $6 billion.
And there are no hookers.
Yeah. That's by yourself. That naked with a bag of cocaine, that's a little sad.
But he's still a step ahead of the guy that stormed the hotel lobby naked with a fire extinguisher up his ass.
We're looking for the bright side this week.
Trying so hard.
We're looking for the upside on this one. Well, don't worry, I can make it worse. Remember I was saying about that, why you shouldn't call attention to yourself? This next guy, I swear to God, he did everything but get a neon sign. This, if you want to talk about starved for attention, it doesn't get much worse than this. Wowzers. Irish man caught having sex with mattress in nursing home car park.
Why are they gonna point out he's Irish? That's racist.
Well, I guess it was in Ireland. It's from somewhere in the UK.
A Welsh dude never had sex with a mattress?
52-year-old man was found having, quote, vigorous sex with a mattress in a nursing home car park while watching porn turned up to full volume on a portable DVD player.
Well, all right.
This was the day the fucks ran out. There were none left to be found anywhere.
In fact, I think you're wrong. There was one fuck left. And that mattress got it. That lucky mattress.
Homeless man Gregory Cole was observed creeping his way into the rear car park at the Laverfold Retirement Home on Asylum Road, Derry, around 5 a.m. on Saturday morning. Officers soon found the man in the lot, immediately heard animalistic and wild, quote, sex noises coming from behind a fence in the car park. Oh, God, even the story says, when the two lucky cops found the exasperated Mr. Cole, they noted his pants were down, he had mounted and was humping his mattress, all while watching pornography on a handheld DVD player. Number of residents in the old people's home were awake at the time, but they did not want to make a statement to the police.
Because they were filming.
Yeah, you assholes, come back later. This is going on the YouTubes.
Was this... It says his mattress. Did he bring it with him?
Yeah, I think so.
Who carries a mattress around?
Well, apparently he's a homeless guy.
You just carry a mattress around? You know how fucking heavy a mattress is?
He's got the mattress and the DVD player, you know.
Do you know how goddamn heavy a mattress
yes,
is?
Yes, I do.
That's
yes,
not
I do.
Portable.
He would, well, and the very fact that it wasn't portable means this was very elaborately planned. He intended to do this shit.
This is a premeditated humping.
The only thing we... Why? What was the point?
Two prior convictions.
That is goddamn.
It's impressive.
That's a lot. Jesus Christ. Get a hobby.
I mean...
Bird watching, maybe. Collect stamps.
Irish people are pretty pale. Maybe if it was a plain old white mattress, he honestly thought it was a chick.
Oh,
Have you
really?
seen that meme, Irish girl sunbathing? No, the other one.
No, I haven't.
It's a girl on the beach and it says Irish girl sunbathing. No, the other one. And it's kind of an optical illusion because next to her there's a girl so pale she blends right into the sand. I'm that girl. Which is why I'm saying Irish chicks are pretty pale. Maybe he just is really bad vision. Now I have Ireland angry. Those are my people.
Yeah. She can get she literally she's got citizenship, so she can just
Exactly. I'm allowed to say this shit because I'm one of them.
Yeah.
We're fucking pale. It's not a secret.
No, it's not. I just I
She's got Irish blood in her. It's understanding, just
that I can only imagine this is a retirement home. So it's the middle of the afternoon. And outside of your window is the porn cranked up to 11, and a guy making love to a mattress. Is it, if I if it were me, I'd be.
Have you ever seen a movie on Netflix called Cockneys versus Zombies?
No.
It's a fantastic movie. It's got Bricktop from
Yeah, I know him.
Snatch in it.
Yes.
But I'm just picturing all those people from that from the old folks home in that movie watching this. They were pretty badass old people, so.
All I know is if it were me and I walked and I went outside and I'm like, Johnny, call the front desk. I'm finally having that stroke. No, I'm pretty sure.
Like the father from Sanford and Son. I'm coming.
What, you see him too? Shit, we're both having a stroke.
Oh no.
What are the odds?
You know, maybe the budget for nursing home entertainment just has really, really dropped this year. Take what you can get.
Although I do have to say, having been in England, I know people in the UK are remarkably unfazed by horrible shit. It's weird. Just incredibly stupid shit happens. They're like, yeah, that happened.
Well, they're just really, really good at not acting phased. They just kind of go, ah.
Okay.
Very well. Where
Well,
we shout expletives.
you were like, motherfucker! And they're like, oh, well, how about that? Our last one tonight comes from China, and I swear to God, had this not come from NPR.
I'm sorry, someone pointed out something. Mikey fan 93. He says, and I can't find vaginas. Maybe this is a symptom of a greater problem.
It could be.
Maybe they really, really need to work on the sex ed overseas.
Now this last one, I swear to you, had this story not come from NPR, had I not found it multiple places, I would have called it bullshit and we wouldn't be doing it tonight. But it did. And I'm not a fan of having kids. Lots of people are. That's cool. I'm not. And this is one more reason why I'm not. Like I've said, remember, I've said this before. They're not stupid. They're just crazy. And this comes to us from China. Chinese high-rise worker left dangling after annoyed boy cuts rope.
Yeah, this was horrible.
A worker in southern China was left hanging from 100 feet up the side of a high-rise apartment building when a 10-year-old boy, apparently annoyed at the construction racket outside his window, decided to cut the safety line on the man's rappelling apparatus. The boy was watching cartoons in his eighth-floor apartment. The worker was outside installing lighting, so the boy took a knife, sliced through the rope that allows the worker to move up and down. According to the English translation of the article, the worker was left dangling midair. He yelled down to a co-worker who called firemen. He was rescued about 40 minutes later. When I was using the Xinhao, I think is his name, Liu.
Yeah. I think the news agency Xinhao. Is called Xinhua.
Xinhua? Okay, see, I don't speak Chinese. It's going to suck when they take over the economy, but I don't speak it. Xinhua quotes the worker saying, "When I was using the electric drill, I felt the lower rope shaking. Then I saw the boy cutting the rope with a knife. That has got to be the most terrifying sight of your life."
That's some shit right out of a 70s horror movie.
You look up and there's a 10-year-old with a knife.
And I'm here to tell you, like, my nephew just turned 9. That's old enough to know what you're doing.
Yep!
My nephew has a pocket knife. He knows very well how to use it. He understands these things very clearly. He's a year younger than this boy. So unless this boy was in some way developmentally disabled, he understood exactly what the fuck he was doing.
He's looking down. He's like, "You son of a bitch. That's not what you want to see!
No.
That's going to haunt your nightmares for the rest of your life. You're going to wake up in a cold sweat and your wife is going to go, "Honey, what's wrong?" He's just, it's the fucking kid
all
with the knife again.
You're drowning out fucking Pokemon. They can only say their own names. The dialogue is not complex.
Buy the son of a bitch a fucking headset! Oh, and...
teach him to... read a book instead. Although it's hard to read a book when it's noisy.
And if you want to know what happened here, I think the reaction of the boy's father tells the story perfectly. His father, surnamed Tang, came back home from work. He gave Liu a sincere apology and compensated him with a new safety rope. "Oh, my bad. My boy tried to murder your ass. Have a rope."
Can you imagine getting that call from work? "You need to come home. Your child just tried to kill somebody."
No, Tara. You know that's not... It would be, "Your child has tried to kill somebody again."
But can you imagine?
He's probably used to this shit by now. He's like, "What? Oh, fuck's sake. Oh, he tried to cut this." Well, that's a new one. That's a new one. Okay. All right.
Well, at least he got an apology and a new rope.
A new fucking... Man, you know if that happened here in America, that'd sue for all fucking worth.
That's like a sitcom ending.
Wah, 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 wah.
Now, Jimmy, say you're sorry to the nice man.
Sorry. We got you a new rope, gee whiz!
About life.
Yes, yeah, you know.
Yeah, that guy's got to be feeling a little shortchanged.
You know, Lou is probably like, "Yeah, I know exactly what I want to do with this fucking rope. Where's the kid? Get that little bastard out here now. I get your fucking Pokemon right here, you son of a bitch.
Make him a rope dog to play with?"
Yes, Tara, make him a rope dog to play with. Jesus, this is how serial killers begin, man!
But you know what the thing is? It's kind of not anymore. This is just fucking kids these days.
And like I said, they're not stupid. They know exactly what they're doing. They're just psychotic!
But a lot of them now are also little fucking sociopaths. Like, empathy has gone out of vogue. You experience some of this today. It's no longer cool to worry about the thoughts and feelings of others. Other people are just extras in your fucking movie. A little scary.
Yeah. Fuck your...
Damn kids today, man.
Fuck your life.
Damn kids with their Pokemans and their Go-Gurt.
Yeah, fuck you trying to live. I gotta watch my Transformers.
I'm not saying all kids are like this, but there's a disturbing number of them that are.
And people, honestly, people are like, "Why don't you want to have kids that make your life so complete?" I'm like, "Because I fucking try to murder people! And you know who's responsible for that shit? Me!
Well, not necessarily. I have two nieces and two nephews, and none of them have ever tried to murder a person. They're lovely little human beings.
Tara, can you honestly say any child that I had would not try to murder someone?
I'm just saying not all children.
You're gonna skirt that question, I see. No, we're gonna skirt that little question.
I'm just saying, I'm weak, so my friends are children. But you gotta teach them empathy, for God's sakes. Because then they grow up and they reach fucking 4chan and it all goes awry. Like,
yeah, I think that the first thing we learned this week is teach your children well or they will murder a son of a bitch.
And then brag about it on fucking Reddit.
Don't underestimate them. That just because they're little does not mean they're not capable of starting some shit. They will start some shit. They're fucked.
And then they'll give you the fucking Puss in Boots cute eyes. And you'll be like, okay. So Bridget is trying to kill one today. Did I lose you? Hello?
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 Oh, okay. I thought I lost you.
Well, yeah, you went a little slow-mo. For a second.
I've been drinking on a job again. Let me tell you something about kids today.
And that's something else we learned this week. Drinking and driving don't mix. Drinking and legislation mix even worse. Just also
don't
messaging.
Drink and lead.
Also messaging. Understand, if you're trying to get rid of a service that will solve drinking and driving, maybe you should not. Drink and drive. You're kind of hurting your cause.
I think we're partially wrong about that, because I think if we got Congress all ripping fucking drunk, some shit might actually get done. If we just, like, laced the Capitol Hill water fountains with tequila, we might actually get some shit done in this country.
We learned this week that while most of us can't find Britain on the map, British people can't find vagina on a map.
That's the one thing Americans have going for us. We can't find the rest of the world, but
we know where our sex parts are.
We know where to stick it.
Yes, we do. We learned this week that some drugs just aren't worth it. Especially the ones that let you unload an arsenal.
I have yet to hear a single goddamn thing that makes me think meth is even remotely alluring.
I
watched all of Breaking Bad.
Meth!
I don't get meth.
No! Meth, it seems like the worst possible fucking thing to do.
It really does.
Even cocaine seems more glamorous than meth.
I get cocaine. I get heroin. And that's saying a lot because my mother worked with heroin addicts most of her career.
Yeah.
And I saw the dodgy end of that. But I get how you could start. I don't get meth.
Yeah, meth is just, you know, when you start snorting a little heroin and whatnot, and then it goes downhill. Meth, you start at the bottom of the hill. You have, there is no down. You're already
started
there.
From the bottom, now we hear, boom. I don't think that's how Drake meant it.
No. We learned that party like a rock star, not as glamorous as it sounds.
No.
Also, be careful at work because someone just might throw a goddamn chair on your head.
I read somewhere once, I'm always careful to look upward because I read somewhere that predators don't tend to look up, and that's why traffic choppers work better than cops on the side of the road. Because humans are predators and your eyes are directed forward, and yeah. So you don't tend to look up. So I think I also read that in the book Jurassic Park. So I'm always very conscious of looking up, just because, you know.
Because chairs.
Look up.
Someone might throw a chair in your goddamn head.
Death from above.
Finally, this week, we learned Well, apparently British people can't find vaginas, but they could find a mattress. Well, the Irish, not British.
Yeah.
Apparently they're just having a vagina problem over there.
You know, cut a hole in a mattress and cut a hole in a mattress and fill it with lube, and if you do enough drugs, it might be close, I guess. Probably not.
Your understanding of anatomy
troubles me. Especially if it's an old-fashioned springs, because then there's going to be, like, tetanus.